Will the land sustain? This is the topic today I am going to explain to you. While using more and more fertilizers, as the part of Green Revolution, we had applied more and more fertilizers into the soil. Together with that, new irrigation methods. Because of this, whether the soil will die or not, whether the soil will lose its fertility or not, it is 100% guarantee that the soil will lose its fertility. While applying the chemical fertilizers, these chemicals will kill the bacteria and other microorganisms which are helping the soil to regain its fertility, and they will die and the soil will lose its fertility. Another thing, while using more and more water through the tube well and other things, the level of groundwater will reduce. The groundwater level table will reduce because of the modern irrigation methods. So these are the various ways by which the more and more usage of modern methods of agriculture affect the soil fertility. Together with that, in Punjab, they use the irrigation methods and the chemical fertilizers in its maximum to increase the production. What happened because of that? The last year they used a good amount of chemical fertilizers. So this year the soil is demanding for more and more chemical fertilizers to get the same production or same amount of production what they got in the last year. So this created a critical problem in Punjab, especially for the farmers of Punjab. Last year, they got a good amount of production, and this year, to get the same level of production, they were in need of more and more chemical fertilizers. This increased the cost of production in agricultural area in Punjab. So the land is going to die if we are using more and more chemical fertilizers. This is a fact. And the next topic is how the land is distributed in Palanpur, in between the various families of Palanpur. So here the families' numbers and other things are given in front of you. Total number of families, which I already told you in the first class, 450 families. Out of that, 150 families, mostly Dalit people, that means one third of the total family, landless. They are not having any single piece of land with them. Next category is 240 families. They are having less than 2 hectares of land in their hands. A very small piece of land, which is not sufficient for to get their income. Less than 2 hectares, only their family matters, family day-to-day purposes, they will get something, not more than that. Another 60 families, they are having more than 2 hectares of land, and in that 60 families, some of the people were having more than 10 hectares of land. So they are the rich landlords, large scale farmers and the medium scale farmers. Those are having more than 2 hectares of land. So the family structure of Palanpur to the land distributed in the way, 450 families, out of that 150 families landless, mostly Dalits, 240 families less than 2 hectares of land, not having sufficient income from the production. The last 60 families, they are having more than 2 hectares of land. They are called as medium or the large scale. Why they are large scale? Some of them are having more than 10 hectares of land. So this is the way in Palanpur the land is distributed. Thank you.